Hello friends, this is Vasant Nayak from Vastech channel. Please subscribe to our channel. We will update latest information for you.
Hello students, last class we have started multiplexer. So let me recall, multiplexer is a device, electronic device, which has many input and one output. So one of the input will be moved to the output or passed to the output depending on the control signal. So we have seen different types of multiplexer. In this class we will see now to design 16:1 multiplexer by using 4:1. So now to design 16:1, how many control signals are required? That is the formula 2^m is equal to n, where n is the number of data lines, 16. So 2^m. Now what is the value of m? m is nothing but 4. So control signals are required is 4, that is A, B, C, D. So we need to use here 4:1 mux. 4:1 mux means 4 inputs are there and 1 output is there. So to design 16:1 by using 4:1, we need 4 such type of mux. We need 4 such type of mux. Then only 16 lines are possible. That is, I can say D0 to D15. 16 lines are possible. So now, what are the control lines for 4:1 multiplexer? Once again, 2^m is equal to n. So that is nothing but 2^2 is equal to 4. So control line is nothing but 2 control lines are required, that is 2 control lines. So here you can see output of this one, once again 4 output is there. So what is the definition of multiplexer? Multiplexer is nothing but many to one, but here 4 output is there. That means we need to connect one more multiplexer, that is 4:1, to get output is equal to 1. And how many control lines this has got? This has also got 2 control line. So what is that? What is that? So 2 control lines, here it is, I can call this is A, B and this is C, D. Now how this works? This works something like this. You can see here A, B, C, D, 4 combination, where A, B is A, B, or A is MSB and D is LSB. That means, here you can see here, this A, B combination changes once in 4 times. That is, 0, 0, till here 0, 1, till here 1, 0, after this 1, 1. So that means, when AB is 0, 0, this IC will get selected. When AB is 0, 1, this IC will get selected. When AB is 1, 0, this IC will get selected. And when AB is equal to 1, 1, this IC will get selected. So now we will see how this works exactly. Let me clearly draw the diagram and explain you. So you can see here the clear diagram. So my dear students, this is what I said, MSB in our truth table. So this can take, AB can take 4 values. So our truth table, you know, 0, 0, 0, 0 to 1, 1, 1, 1. So when the value of AB is, this is A, B, CD, when the value of AB is 0, 0, this line will be selected. So now let me take one value, that is 0010, which line will be selected? You have to see AB 00, first line is selected. That means this will enable this IC. In this IC 1010 means here also 0001, four combinations are possible. 1011 means D2 will get selected and moved to the output. Output is nothing but D2, whatever value of D2 is moved into the output. Suppose your D2 is 1, then output is 1. D2 is 0, output is 0. Is it clear? So once again, let me take one more value. I will take now 1011. First see, 10. This is ABCD. Once again, I am writing here ABCD. 10 is this one. This line will get selected, and you can see here this line is connected to this IC. In this IC, once again, what is the value of CD? 11. CD is 11. Here, all these are interconnected. CDs are interconnected here. So CD is 11 means 00011011. So D11 is selected, and D11 is moved to the output. So if the D11 is 1, output is 1. If the D11 is 0, output is 0. This is called as design of 16:1 multiplexer by using 4:1 multiplexers. So totally how many 4:1 multiplexers are required? We need 5 numbers here. And how many control lines are there? 4 control lines are there. So here something, it works like in this way. You have to think in this way, reverse engineering way. So from this end to this end. So now next one is design 32:1 mux using two numbers of 16:1 mux only. You should not use any other one. So now how to design this one? To design this one, 16:1 multiplexer. Now onwards, I will not write once again how many control lines are required. Here it is mentioned. You can see input lines we need 32, output is 1, control line is 5. 5 control lines are required. Now he says you have to use only 16:1. If I use 16:1, this has got 16 inputs. D0 to D15, you have to mention like this only. D16 to D31. So now 32 inputs are over here. Now output here, you cannot use one more multiplexer, 2:1. No. He says only you have to use 16:1 mux only. So what is the other alternative way? Output is connected to OR gate. But we have control lines is 5. Here control lines are 4. So what about the MSB control line, that is A, B, C, D, E? What about MSB control line? This one, what we are doing is we are connecting this one to an inverter in between. So we will connect like this. So you may ask, why we are connecting like this? So let me write truth table. Here I cannot write entire truth table, but let me explain you. I will write here A, B, C, D, 5 variable. So first one is 5 variable. So first one is so A, B, C, D and E, 5 variables. First one is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, right? And this 0 will remain same for 16 combination till this B, C, D, E becomes 1, 1, 1. After that, this becomes 1 and this becomes 0, 0, 0, 0. And finally, this becomes 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. Another 16 combination. So this is 16 combination, or 0 to 15, 16 combination. This is 16 combination. So here A can take two values. One is 0, second one is 1. That's why When A is 0, this is disabled. This is enabled. When A is 1, this is enabled. So you may ask how it works exactly. Let me explain you once again here clearly. See. So enable is active low signal. Please remember now, enable is active low signal. Active low signal means those signals we represent by bubble, using bubble, and active low signals are those which causes something to happen with the low level signal. Something to happen with the low level signal, that is called as active low signal. So active low signals are those signals okay sorry for the interrupt active low signals are those signals it causes something to happen when it is low rather than when it is high. So the way we can explain active low signals are those signals which causes something to happen when it is low rather than when it is high. So we represent active low signal by using bubble. So now you can see, my dear student, here you can see this is active low signal. Now when A is equal to 0, see, this is active low signal. Now A is equal to 0, starting A is equal to 0. When A is equal to 0, this 0 and 0 get cancelled, and this IC will get enabled. And based on the rest of the combination BCD, particular line is selected and moved to the output. When A is equal to 1, when A is equal to 0, this is activated. Then what will happen here? 0 goes to this inverter, output of the inverter is 1, and here we are giving I level. Then this IC will get disabled. Clear? So now, when A is equal to, now when A is equal to 1, this IC will get disabled. 1 will go to this inverter and output of the inverter becomes 0, and this IC will be enabled. So based on the combination of once again BCD, one of the line is selected here from this IC and moved to the output. So this is 32:1 multiplexer using two numbers of 16:1 multiplexer. So now in the exam, if they ask using 16:1 and 2:1, then you should not use this AND gate. Instead of that, what you do? You have to use your 2:1 multiplexer. 2:1 multiplexer. You have to use 2:1 multiplexer, and you have to write here A here. And this is the output. Why? And you should not put inverter here. You need not use enable. If they ask you to implement by using 2:1 and 16:1, then this is the answer. So now, my dear students, we will see one more problem. Design 8:1 by using 2:1. See, very, very important problems. 2:1. 8:1, how many control lines are required? 2^m is equal to 8. That is, 3 control lines are required, right? So what are those control lines? A, B, C. Here 3 stages are there. You will come to know stages. Why? Because here 8 input by using 2:1. So 2:1, how many IC you have to use? 1, 2, 3, 4. Then only you can make 8 input. But you see here, output is equal to, once again, this will give one output. So 4 outputs. What is the definition of multiplexer? Many to one. So here we cannot stop. So you have to continue. So now, once again, one more stage, 2:1. Then it will give 2 more output here. Once again. So this is MSB. This is LSB. So this is 8:1. Now you may ask, like, how this will work, sir. For that, let me explain. Without any doubt, A, B, C. This is the combination, control lines, right? We know A is MSB. So, you know, truth table for A, B, C, three variable, 000, 001, 010, 011, 100, 101, 110, and 111, my dear students. So, you see MSB, it changes only twice during this 8 combination. That is, either it can take 0 or a 1. You see, my dear students, A, B, it changes. It can take, what are the combinations? What are the combination of the B? 0011 0011 0011 0011. So B also take 0 and 1. Now what is the combination of C? C also take either 0 or 0 or 1. So now let me take 100. Which line is selected? A, B, C. Put here, A, B, C. A is 1. A is 1 means this one. This IC will get enabled. In that, B is 0. So, this IC will get enabled. So, signal goes like this. This IC will get enabled. In that 0 once again. That means D4 line is moved to the output. So, actual working is like this. To explain, this is the way. Is it clear? 8:1 by using 2:1 multiplexer. So now we'll proceed now. So now 32:1 using 8:1 multiplexer. See here, you have to see the question properly. 32:1 using 8:1 multiplexer. So now, how to design this one? If you use 8:1, how many numbers of 8:1 is required? 4 numbers. Fine. Then, if he mention 4:1, then you can use here 4:1. But he says here, design 32:1 using 8:1 mux only. And sometimes he says use decoder. So if he says 4:1, very simple. Here you will get AB. But here the condition is not like so. So what we are doing, we will use an OR gate. But how this IC will get selected? We are using decoder. So based on the combination of the decoder, AB, 00, 01, 10, 11, all these are will connected to enable signal. See. Enable signal. That means when AB is 00, this IC will get selected. AB is 01, this IC will get selected. AB is equal to 10, this IC will selected. And 11, this IC will get selected. And based on the combination of CDE, particular input is moved to the output. I hope you understood this one because I have already explained the same logic previously. So you understood this one. So now, we'll see implement a function. Function of three variable, implement function of three variable by using 8:1 mux. So very simple here, he has given three variable. So directly you can implement by using 8:1 because three variable can give how many miniterms? 8 miniterms. Here it is SOP. So SOP miniterms are mentioned here. 8 miniterms it will give. SOP 8 fundamental this one it will give. So SOP terms are mentioned here. So 0, 4, 5, 6. Then what is other terms? Other term is 1, 2, 3, 7. That is POS term. So that is 0. That is should be grounded. So here 1, 2, 3 and last one is 7. Is grounded. Here 7 is not mentioned, but 7, 1, 2, 3, 7 is grounded and rest are connected to VCC. Very simple. But please remember to mention 7451, because 8:1 we have used in the lab. 7451, and you try to mention strobe signal and ground signal, and both are connected to the ground, and try to mention output Y and VCC. All this you properly mention. So now here implement this one by using 16:1 multiplexer. See, very simple. Now 16, 4 variable, 16 combination. Directly you can implement this one by using 16:1. See here, 16:1. So what are the terms here? 2, 5, 6, 9, 11, 6, 14 are 1. R1. That means those terms you have to connect it to VCC. Rest of the terms you have to connect it to, the rest of the pin you have to connect it to ground. That's all. Very simple. And see here, represent 32:1. This is also simple. So these are the some of the important problem from this section. So we'll proceed now. So my dear students, with this we have completed a multiplexer related problem. Now next classification of multiplexer is called as Nibble multiplexer. Next classification of multiplexer is called as Nibble multiplexer, that we'll see in the next session. Yeah, Nibble multiplexer. For Nibble multiplexer, I will use a PDF from Digital Principles and Application book. So the Nibble multiplexer, let me directly go to the circuit diagram of Nibble multiplexer, how it works, we'll see. So Nibble multiplexer is used to move or pass 4 bits at a time. 4 bits are called as Nibble, 8 bits are called as byte. So Nibble normally multiplexer is a device which moves one of the input to the output, one bit. But Nibble multiplexer moves 4 bits. So you can see here, group of 4 bits, that is A0 to A3 and B0 to B3 are connected here. It is connected to the NAND gate. Through NAND gate is connected, output of the NAND gate is connected to OR gate, and you will get the output here Y0, Y1, Y2, Y3. Now, how this works? That is the question. So when select is 0, this line is connected to these NAND gates, and we know any AND gate, if the one of the input is 0, that is we can say it is disabled, output is 0, right? AND gate. So you don't think about this now NAND gate, you isolate it. AND gate, if one of the input is 0, output is 0, irrespective of other input, output is 0. So now this will not work. Then which will work? 0 here, 1. This is 1, this is 1, this is 1, and this is 1. Now we will take any data value here, 1, 0, 1, 1. We will take something like this. So now, this is 1 here, this is 0, this is 1, this is 1, right? Now, 1 and 1 is 1, this is 0, this is 1. This is 1. Clear? Now output of this one is 0, this is 1, this is 0, and this is 0. Now what is the output of this one? What is the output of this one? So for that, let me explain that also. So I will rub this one. What is the output of this one? So now it is connected here. Here it is 0, and this is 0, this is 0, and this is 0. Let me take this input as 1, 1, 1. I want to pass this Nibble now. So what is the input here? 1, 1, 1, 1. Now 0, 0, 0, 0. Then output is 1, 1, 1, 1. So now this is odd here. So now this is 0. Here this is 0. Here it is a 1. Here it is 1. This input is 1. This input is 1. Right. This input is 0 and this input is 1. This input is 0 and this input is 1. Now, 0 inverted becomes 1. 1 inverted becomes 0 plus. That is 1. Yes. 1 inverted 0 and 1 inverted 0 becomes 0. 0 inverted 1 plus 1 inverted 0. This becomes 1. 0 inverted 1, 1 inverted 0 becomes 1. So what we got now? We got this 1. So if you want to move this 1, what you have to do? You have to make this is 1 and this is 1. Select is 1. That means when the select is 0, left side of the gates will be enabled and left side of the bits, left side of the bits, not LSB, left side of the bits, that is A0, A1, A2, A3 will be moved. When it is select is 1, right side of the bits will be moved to the output. That is called as nibble multiplexer. So this is the explanation for nibble multiplexer. So next, so now, realize this expression using 8 is to 1 multiplexer. So to realize this one, this is somewhat given in this one, expression form. So try to further expand this one. So here which is missing? C. So here I will write A bar B into 1, B bar C into 1. So that 1 I will consider here C, this 1 I will consider here A. Now if you multiply, you can see these are the terms. Now A bar B C, that is D3. D3 means what? 0, 0, truth table. 0, 0, 1 is D0, right? How you write this 0, 0, 0? You write 0, 0, 0 is A bar, B bar and C bar in SOP. 0, 0, 1, how you write? D1. And what is that? A bar, B bar and C. Now, what is this? D3. D3 means somewhere it comes here. D2 and D3. D3 is nothing but 0, 1, 1. Right? That you will write A bar, B, C. D3. So, this is D3. This is D2, D4, D0, D7. So, all these are 1. Rest are 0. So, what do you do? Here is a implementation. All those terms are connected to 1, rest are 0 and implement it. Very simple. Once again, you see this one expression. Simple expression. You have to implement this one. A bar B, B bar C, A, B, C. So which is missing here? Here it is A is missing. Then here it is C is missing. So try to solve this one. First here A is missing. Then C is missing. So you can use, you can implement this one is one by using 8 is to 1 multiplexer or 4 is to 1 multiplexer. If you want to implement this one by using 4 is to 1 multiplexer, then one variable you have to take like EVM. That is, here which is missing, you that you write. After that, you will get this expression. Now here nothing is there. 1. 1. This is C bar. This is C bar and this is C. Now you see this combination. A bar B bar I will write first. A bar B bar. that is 0, 0. Along with that, we have C bar, right? Then second one is A bar B. A bar B, A bar B, 0, 1. Along with that, which is there? Along with that, we have I will take C is equal to 0. If you take C is equal to 0, C bar becomes 1. So, here also we have something C bar, A bar B. Then next one is A bar B bar 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. A B bar. With A B bar, you can see here C bar is there. Then last one is A B. With A B, C is there. So this one you have to implement. So you take this first one as D0, second one as first one is A bar B bar. You can see C bar here. Let me explain once again. Here, I will write this one. I will try to expand this one because you have to implement. Here, you cannot put C because you have to implement by using 4 is to 1 multiplexer. That is the problem. If you want to implement this one by using 8 is to 1 multiplexer, then here missing term is C. That you write C plus C plus C bar. Here missing term is A plus A bar. Then ABC, right? But it is not so. It is not so. Why? In a sense like you have to implement by 4 is to 1. You know, do you remember EVM? So let me recall EVM. When EVM we use, what we do? We will isolate third one, third variable. Right? When four variable we will use, we will isolate D. When the three variable we will use, we will isolate C. Right? Here also you have to do same thing. So first combination you write 0, 0. Second combination you write 0, 1. This is 0, 1. A bar B. Which is A bar B here? This one. A bar B, nothing is there. 1. So, 1. Third combination is A, B bar. Here C bar is there. Fourth combination A, B. Here C is there. So, you can see now D0 is C bar here. D1 is 1. D2 is C bar. D3 is C. We got. Now, implementation, very simple, right? 4 is to 1, A, B, C is, you have to take like this. You remember in the lab, 8 is to 1 multiplexer, 16 is to 1, you implemented by 8 is to 1. There we take D, like that only you have to take here. So, now you see, D0 is C bar. So, what I will do, here I will take C, here I will take C, when you move this to the inverter, this becomes C bar and that is connected here. Then D1 is a 5 volt. This one. D2 is a C bar, once again here. D3 is a C. So this is the output. See, some students, they will not write output strobe and all. Please write and mention 4 is to 1 mux. So, my dear students, with this, we have completed a multiplexer problem. So many problems. I think I have solved around 15 to 20 problems in the multiplexer. So, now you will be able to solve. You are capable to solve a multiplexer problem in the exam. So, now we will move to the next session, that is demultiplexer. So, my dear students, demultiplexer is the device which has one input and many output. That means that input is moved to the one of the output based on the control lines. So here you can see, here my dear students, you can see this is the one input and is the one input and many output. Based on this control lines, this input is moved to the one of the output. So this is demultiplexer. So 1 to 2 demux, this is the circuit diagram for 1 to 2 demux. So now we have different IC, 1 to 16 demux, 1 to 8 demux, 1 to 4 demux. These are the three types of IC. But the one beautiful features of this IC is demultiplexer can use as a decoder also. Demultiplexer can be used as a decoder also. That time we'll call 4 to 16 decoder, 3 to 8 and 2 to 4. Now you may ask how. So first we'll take 1 to 16 demultiplexer. I will write here only, or I will use the blackboard. So so this is demultiplexer IC. We will take this is demultiplexer IC. One is the input. This input we will call data. This input we will call a data. So it is 1 to 16. How many outputs are there? Output you have to write Y0 to Y15. Don't write D. Y0 to Y15. This is the output. How many control lines are required? We know 4 control lines are required. A, B, C, D. Now, other than that, we have one signal that is called as strobe signal that is grounded. This is multiplexer, demultiplexer. Now, other than that, we have ground. Now, same IC you can use a decoder. Now, what is decoder? Decoder is similar to demultiplexer, but it doesn't have data line. It doesn't have data line. Then how it works? It will select one of the output lines based on the control line. For example, if A, B, C, D is 0, 0, 0, 0, it will select D, Y, 0. 0, 0, 0, this one, 1, it will select Y, 1, that one. In that way, it works. So now, how we can use this IC as a decoder? Only thing is, you connect this to ground. Data is connected to ground. Then, it works like 4 control lines and 16 output lines. So this one is equal to 4 is to 16 decoder. We will call it is 4 is to 16 decoder. 1 to 16 demux IC can be used as 4 is to 1, 4 is to 16 decoder. So this is the explanation. Now I will take you back to our PDF. So, this is 4 to 16. Similarly, 1 to 8, it is called as 3 to 8 decoder. 1 to 4 is called as 2 to 4 decoder. So now, design, 1 to, design, 1 to, 32 demultiplexer by using 1 to 16 demultiplexer. Similar to that problem. So 1 to 32, for 1 to 32, how many control lines are required? We have already solved this one, 5 control lines are required. So he says like you have to use only 1 to 16 demultiplexer. You should not use any other this one. So to use 1 to 16 demultiplexer only, so what do you have to do? So what do you have to do here? See, I will connect 1 to 16 multiplexer, 1 to 16 multiplexer. Then here this is Y0, this is Y15 and Y16 and Y31. Last one is Y31. 31 output I got. This is BCDE. Then what to do? I have enable signal. In between enable signal, I will put one inverter and I will call this is A. And this is data line. I will connect, interconnect data line. Now, data line is interconnected, not grounded. Now you see 32 bit A, B, C, D, E. This A becomes 0 and remains 0 till 16 combination. After that, 1 till 16 combination. So when it is 0, this will be get selected and input is moved to the output based on the control lines. And when it is 1, this will get selected and input is moved to the output. So next one, decoder. So already explained decoder, you can see here 4:1 decoder. What we did, we have connected data to ground, data and strobe is ground. Now design 5 to 32 decoder by using 74154. So 5 to 32, so see 5 to 32, don't get confused. 5 to 32 is nothing but 1 to 32 decoder, sorry, demultiplexer. Just now we solved 1 to 32 demultiplexer. So in 1 to 32 demultiplexer, what we did, same here also, only changes. See, if you understand the logic, very simple. Only changes here is data is grounded. Why? Decoder doesn't have data input. Data is grounded. Decoder doesn't have data input. But we are using demultiplexer IC that has got data input. That I will ground it. I will interconnect and I will ground it. Then this becomes a 5 to 32 decoder. Otherwise, you can call 1 to 32 demultiplexer. So this is the problem solution for this one. So now next one is BCD to decimal decoder. So what is this BCD to decimal decoder? BCD to decimal decoder is the one which is used to decode BCD numbers. BCD means binary coded decimal, that is used to represent 0 to 9. So this decoder also, decoder is used to represent 0 to 9. This is also called as 1 of 10 decoder. So it has got only Y0 to Y9. And ABCD is the control. But it can represent only 0 to 0, 0, 0, 0 to 1, 0, 0, 1. That is called as BCD decoder, BCD decoder. So you can see what are the application of the BCD decoder. In the exam, they may ask write BCD decoder and application. So here you can see decoder is connected, 7445 is connected, something like this. Four control lines are there. You don't remember pin number. Pin number is not required. And all these are connected to this LED. And LED is connected with the common, this method. What is that? Common anode method. It is connected. You can see here. So I know this one is connected to VCC with the resistor. Now you see 0000. First one will get selected and this LED will glow. This LED will glow. 0010, second LED will glow. Like that it will indicate a particular number. If you think like this is 0, this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, this is 7, this is 8, this is 9, then particular number, it indicates a particular number. So now, three functions are given. You have to implement this one by using decoder. Very simple. Decoder doesn't have a data line. So here you have to write first function and the output of this function 000001. So this is something like this 000001010. Now here it is given first function. So for the first function, see three function, to implement three function we need three OR gate. First function 046, because it is SOP. So SOP 0th this one term you take, connected to OR gate, And fourth one you take connected to OR gate. This is not first Y0 to Y7 like this. Similarly, function second is implemented by like this. Similarly, function third is implemented by this. Very important question from the exam point of view. So many times this question got repeated and very easy to implement this one. Here you have to write 3 to 8 decoder and this is the output and this is better. You represent control lines. And once again, remember here you write the output. Output you have to represent like this function F2, F3. So, my dear students, now we'll move to the next one, 7-segment decoder. So, all those information we'll see in the next class. Thank you.